Alright, this is Penguin Singer, and I'm going to be playing Desktop Dungeons. Alright, let's see what this is. Okay, so in Desktop Dungeons, death rise swiftly and frequently. If you're already familiar with this game, you can reach for the challenge and see about doing better. If you're a newer player, it is recommended that you opt for the formal tutorial dungeons instead. I guess I'll go for the tutorial. Hello, welcome to Desktop Dungeons, a randomly generated turn-based puzzle roguelike thing of a dungeon engineer and heroes and monsters like. Get started, click on the sign of your character and read what it has to say. Green's Adventurer, your Legendary Depths of the Lost, Tutorial, One Dungeon. Whatever you see in the random cave networks left in the Old Kingdom, no one knows what they're here for, but everyone agrees that they're awesome. To your chance, typical Desktop Dungeons monster, you'll find that combat in this case is surprisingly detailed, nuanced, and flexible. For now, however, just click on the baddie until he dies. After that fight, take a chunk of your health. You'll notice this on your character's stat panel, and the green red bar next to you in the dungeon view. Reveal some new terrain by exploring, and you'll steadily recover health. Backtracking doesn't count, sorry. Okay. So down the diagonal movement, you really are a clever little biscuit, aren't you? Bad guy, meat man, copyright infringement, likely. Okay, two I'm assuming is his level. Seriously, stop trying to attack this monster, it's a ball. Really constrained rage as it is. Pacify the and these tutorial monsters takes effort, you know. If you have no engineering creatures, our state of the art bow regeneration track will keep track of the health for you. Worry though, they heal just as easily as you do. Can you measure the tutorial one fair play committee has decided to put these enemies here in the interest of your sustained enjoyment and survival. Destroy them at your leisure. You can find more useful information by right-clicking on a target enemy's main selected. Side panel will populate itself with more detailed actions. You'll be able to view status effects in more detail. Okay. Great, check the right side of the screen. You can fight this bandit by clicking on the attack icon or mouse over its portrait for more information on stats effects. Don't worry, they're interesting but harmless right now. Great, you've earned enough experience to level up. You've been fully healed and your stats have improved, making it far easier to take on annoyances like level 2 meat man. Ah yeah, you're certified badass now. You should go find something else to kill. Gads, it's a goat. Get out of there, adventurer. Take the side pass before it eats your soul. You do well to heed this advice. The numbers show that this enemy simply too strong. If you move past the goat, it won't attack unless you attack first. I just ganked dead. You're going to die. Hope you enjoyed your tutorial one tour. We offer feedback forms, but you know, you're gooey dead and stuff. Desktop Dungeons is a hard game. You have to die a lot until you become more experienced. Attack the goat and accept your defeat. This will complete the first tutorial. Snicker, wish to continue. Adventurers met an inconveniently early end. Tutorial complete. Of the people who escaped the initial attack on the camp, many perished in the deadly underground dungeons. So do I click on the flag now? Fresh new adventure inside a fresh new dungeon. Here's hoping that this way you explore is fortunate, or fortunate the less. Straight to work by attacking the warlock. Warning, attack 5%. Use only in case of extreme emergency and/or damage dissatisfaction. You walk over attack 5 and permanently increase your damage by 10%. If you're lucky enough to find, we'll grab it as soon as possible. Standard adventure constitution boosters for heroes who want to be more constituent. Health power-ups operate in the same way that attack power-ups do, but increase your maximum health instead of your damage. Now they won't note that they won't actually heal you, so don't just leave them lying around. Arcanian flies use for spellcasting and liberative endeavors. Mana power-ups increase your maximum mana by 1. This is particularly valuable because mana doesn't increase with character level. We'll cover spellcasting and mana use a little later. We said ignore this, not get perforated by it. Side passage is friendlier, easier on. And this is more like it, you just discovered the dungeon exit. Retirement is the most glorious way to end a session, sometimes it's your only choice. Unless you count Impaled by the Killer Goat as a very viable option. Okay. Just dungeon and world. To the legendary dungeon of hidden treasures while exploring, want to help yourself to a complimentary glyph of fiery dew. Congratulations, you've just found your first spell glyph. These ancient and potent artifacts allow you to channel your magic essence in a variety of tasks, in this case clicking on things and making them go blue. Click on the pick up button that's appeared in the side panel on the glyph and move to your inventory. You may also press the spacebar on your keyboard or double click the item in the dungeon. time to put your newly discarded magic skills to the test. Click on the spell glyph in your inventory, then click on the target. Not only does it make sense for explosion, but cast spells won't let enemies retaliate. If you need quick mass access to do an attack, such as the ever reliable fireball, click on a foe and drag your cursor to another block. This brings up a quick menu of your available fighting options. It works on the player and other dungeon elements too, if you have the appropriate equipment. If you're running out of mana, explore the dungeon to regenerate. This works similarly to health regeneration. Pass is not open to standard tour, please do not enter, particularly if you're the type who would readily steal lots and lots of gold. By the way, if you're wondering where your inventory screen has disappeared to, try clicking on the tabs beneath the side panel to bring it back, or just press tab on your keyboard. As you level up, your spell damage will increase. You usually won't hit as hard as a regular attack, but the fact that enemies can't hit you back is a major plus. Oh, it sounds like the treasure room was a trap. Use the thing big and heavy sliding into a place from the dungeon above. The creature is blocking your exit and seems to be immune to magic. Spellgriff won't be much use here, so why not convert it? Shin is a new way to recycle any unwanted inventories. Click and hold your mouse right over the glyph, drag it to the conversion box in the bottom right corner of the inventory panel. Great stuff. Doing this to items fills up your conversion bar. The item has enough conversion value, the bar resets and your character gains an extra stat boost. In this case, converting should have given you enough extra attack power to deal with this golem, defeat it, and leave the dungeon with your hard-won cash. Okay. Go to the outpost. Alright. Kingdom Administrator, remember this moment well, for you have just taken your first tentative steps down the long and glorious path. Under your guidance, we'll build a kingdom to challenge the Golden Thumb Sevens. Here it is, your hour of triumph. The goal in this dungeon is simple. Find the goat boss, slay it, and leave the dungeon with its trophy as proof of your deed. Not only will you prove yourself ready to move on from these annoying tutorials, you will become the new kingdom's first celebrated hero. Ah, you've picked up the welcome sight of Burn Day Rath's glyph. Add it to your inventory the same way you did last time. On the pickup button. suckers. Items such as weapons armor can be added to your inventory. Most items will be considered in use as soon as you pick them up. There's usually no need to special equip them. Grab the sword and check the improvement to your damage rating. Keep picking up items as you find them and note how they start filling your inventory slots. Carry up to 6 major items at once. If you want to convert an item from the ground without putting it in your inventory, convert by clicking the conversion box in the bottom right corner of the item's description panel. Potions are a special kind of stackable item that take up far less space than most other items. Unlocking them is always nice. Waits for you at the end of this corridor. No hints, no handholding. Use a combination of your items, spells, and character skills. See if you can defeat it and take its horn. Ooh. That did not go as well as I hoped. Okay. Let's try this again. Here, the Guardian found the trophy you can claim grabbing a monster trophy and the dungeon session, but you can hang around as long as you want before it takes me. Victory, your hero parades the muddy streets of your rapidly growing settlement. Goat horn clasped in one mailed fist. Rose petals and jubilant shouts alike fill the air as townsfolk come out to celebrate. Amidst the glee, a lone figure approaches you as you recline your administrator's parade viewing chair. Alright, I got 150 gold off of that. Quest unlocked guild expansion. There's more than one way to slay the average dungeon monstrosity in the kingdom's population is one of diverse talents and interests, magic users, holy men, and even common pet purses are interested in fighting the good fight, especially if there's money involved. Thank you. I guess this one. Alright, let's upgrade. Alright. Class unlocked, wizard. Complete. Custom locked city expansion. Our brand new kingdom is Stonegrave Peril. The denizens of nearby dungeons are breathing down our necks. Bravier wanders in and slays the leaders in each area. The rest should be demoralized enough to scatter. Alright, well, guess that's it for now. Thanks for watching. If you have any suggestions for how I could improve this Let's Play, please let me know. And if you enjoyed it and want to see more, leave a like and subscribe for content. Thanks, and bye.